chess pokud tu tak přistanenko. Jak Oscar.
Yes, I bet you have.
This is what Star Wars fandom has become. Read what she's saying and imagine what the blanks are. This is what it's come down to, a bunch of feral, psycho, ill-mannered, amoral, obsessed, sex-crazed Fruit Loops, and they're ruining Star Wars and they're ruining the fandom. They're killing it. All right, so I'm back. This is gonna be a short one. A friend of mine subtweeted a tweet by a girl in which she was saying, and this is a girl, it's not, I'm kind of glad she was an older woman because I'd really be like, she said she would sell her family to suck Adam Driver's, I put the tweet up so you guys can see it. She would punt her beagle to lick his, and I can't remember what the other part was, you guys will see it, and then your little imaginations can run wild. Disney expects to make money off the Rise of Skywalker, and they are enabling this shit. Honest to God, Bob Iger, do you expect me to go see this movie if I gotta sit with people like that? Really? Do you honestly expect me, a 51-year-old woman, to go to see this movie, to bring my nieces and nephews, to bring my sons and daughter to see this movie? When they're filthy, dirty-minded scum talking like this? Let me explain to you guys. When I was that age, Harrison Ford was married. You know, my favorite actor, I think, is the most handsome man in the world. But there's a modicum of respect that I have had and still have for him. I don't think about him. There's a public outside voice and an inside voice. Keep the inside voice inside. That's what grown-ups do. That's what I was taught by my parents, who actually gave a shit about what I was doing in my spare time and tried to give me a character building childhood. Okay, you don't treat people like that, especially people you say you admire. So you got this girl saying that, and of course all the railers are like, you're in my mind. It's getting old. It is really getting old. So this is my opinion. Disney, Lucasfilm, Bob Iger, you either announce that there is no Reylo and you put the kibosh on this shit so real Star Wars fans feel like they still have a foot in the door, that we matter, and give Adam Driver his humanity back instead of a sex object for women my age who obviously have never had sex before, or teenage girls, or millennial women who view men in such a disgusting, misandrous way that you could call it bigotry, or you lose the fans forever. Fans like me. Fans who have been here for 40 years. Fans who wanted to give the legacy to the next generation and won't if we're subject to Reylo, to filth, to dehumanizing crap like this. Okay? I can't deal with this anymore. I really can't. It's gotten out of hand. And oh, by the way, you'd think someone at Disney, you'd think J.J. Abrams, you'd think Chris Terrio, you'd think Mark Hamill might say something in public about middle-aged women jumping on Broadway stages screaming Kyle Ron. You think you would. You think you'd have that. Someone would say something about a stupid outlook. You think someone would say, this has gone too far. You think someone would say it's gone too far when his wife was threatened, when his baby was threatened, when they were wishing death on both of them, when they were wishing Adam would divorce her and marry Daisy, when they were attacking Daisy's fiance. You'd think you'd do something about it. I know your marketing firm's going, well, you know, if we market it this way and la, 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 because all PR is good PR. No, it's not. Do you honestly think this gets people like me, people like Ethan Van Sciver, people like Craig and John and Jay and Nazareth and Baz Taylor and all these other people who are huge Star Wars fans who have children who they want to share with, Mark, Abu Nas, Demanjani, Ivan, you know, all these other people. Do you honestly think this is going to get us to go see this movie when we're subject to having to sit there watching these semi-retarded, insane, crackhead lunatics go nuts over a guy, A, who would never touch him with a 10-foot pole, B, who is married, and C, over a what they call a ship, which is just bizarre anyway, that's likely not going to happen. Do you honestly think I want to sit there in an audience listening to this shit? Do you? Do you? I've had enough. I've had it up to here. Do something about it. Say something. Poor Daisy kills it in public. Two steel Saunders. And it goes in through one ear, rattles around, and out the other. She kills it again on IGN. Goes in through one ear and out the other. I mean, she's basically their self-insert so they can be sperm receptacles or something. I'm tired of this. I have reached peak bullshit with Raylo. Okay? So, get rid of him. Say something now. Do it now. Do it in the months preceding this movie's release. Because I'm going to tell you something. If it gets right up there, and then, well, if it gets right up there and they don't get it, they're going to freak. They're going to go nuts. So you might as well tell them now, okay? You might as well leak out who she is now. And don't use the Palpatine thing either, because that's bullshit. And I know it's bullshit. Because it makes no sense in the canon at all. Even your crappy canon, okay? It doesn't make any sense in anything ever anywhere. And trust me, I know one thing's for sure certain. George Lucas probably hates it. So why are we subject to it? Why do we have to sit there and listen to this shit on Twitter? On Twitter! I mean, you report him, and instead, you're the one that gets in trouble. That's another thing that pisses me off. You report these bitches, you're the one that gets in trouble. They can say the most vile, disgusting, perverted, filthy, dehumanizing things about Adam Driver, verbally assault his wife, threaten her, and nothing happens. But the moment you call them out for their bullshit, you're the one that gets in trouble. And you think you're going to make money on The Rise of Skywalker. You're not, if you don't take care of this shit. And I'm telling you now, I've worked in politics. I know how the PR game goes. Bullshit walks, and this is bullshit, and no one's going to be around to pay. You know, how much money you're going to need to make up for how much money this movie's costing, because I know it's costing a lot of money. I've heard astronomical numbers. Okay, Galaxy's Edge is dying. The franchise is limping into the grave as we speak, and yet we get to hear about Raylo. You don't control what StarWars.com says. You don't control what the social media says. You don't control any of that. And they wonder why the fans are pissed. So here's the deal. Raylo fans aren't Star Wars fans. They're obsessed with Adam Driver. They say filthy, disgusting things about him. They attack the actual fans who spend money on collectibles and stuff, who go to see the movies over and over again, and bully us. We're tired of it. We're effing tired of it. So, I'm going to give you a choice. You either got Raylo or you got Star Wars, but you can't have both. Choose wisely. Because if you choose poorly, the end is nigh. In fact, I can see that coming up at the end of this bizarre tunnel ride we've been on. And it ain't pretty. The franchise deserves better than to be a receptacle for the insanity and fantasies of a pack of mentally ill, scary, hormone-wired females. This is Steph signing out. See you on the galaxy. See you on the cantina. Please remember to tip the Wookiee bartender 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos, no Ray Nobodies, no Ray Palpatines, no Ray Kenobis, no Ray Jins, no Ray Luke's clone hand, no Ray clone of Leia, no Ray Shmi Skywalker. That's no Ray reincarnation of Anakin, no Ray Immaculate Conception. This is for real Star Wars. I mean, that shit. If you're gonna have a fight, take it out in the alley. Gunfights, you take this shit out in the street. See you on the galaxy, Skywalker.